Today I'm gonna talk with something my experience in Italy and my experience that I lived with my fellowship, and it's gonna be something very different from all the other experience. Mostly because you can't really touch. It's not stone, preservation. It's not wood. It's nothing that you can touch. But it's something. It's sound. So I am a musician, but a musician, but I'm a music educator, a video maker, and an ethnomusicologist. And also another name there, even more obscure, that is called is organology. Who knows? What is that?
The Ecoli?
Nothing to do. Organology is the study of the musical instruments, story, etc. So if you ask me to give a little bit of insight of what ethnomusicology is, so ethnomusicology is the study of music in its cultural context. So, and yes. Yes, no. Please don't put that online. Yeah, so we approach music as a social process in order to understand not only what music is, but why it is, what music means to its participants and audiences, and how those meanings are conveyed. And also what we do, what we often do, is preserve music heritage. So we often go to people and bother them and say, please, can you sing me that song that you learned when you were very young? Because it's very precious to us, for us to preserve, because nobody knows anymore that song, that story. So when some old people that preserve that song will die, nobody will know about the music, about that melody, about that particular story. So that we preserve those stories, those musical stories, and those sounds. That's what we do. It's strange, but it's whatever. So as part of my my fellowship, I had the chance to go to Italy. This is Italy. It's Italy. I wanted to improve my skills as a musician. I'm a folk musician. I play a lot of different kind of music, but in the last time of my career, I've been more involved in folk music here in Australia. I'm also a video maker. I like to preserve music with video as well, because music is something alive. You can't only record the music, you have to see what the musician is doing to understand what he's playing and his movements. There's a lot you can learn about watching the musician play. Also, I wanted to improve my skills as a music archivist. So that's what we do, as I told you before. We store music. What we do with that music, where we put that information, those audio files or the video files or the history. So I went to talk with the archives and music archivists, and there's a bit of confusion in Italy, so I think it's not a very big reference to go to learn things, because there's a lot of different methodologies. So I will much from them, but I think that unlearning allowed me to learn to set up my own methodology and follow what I was doing before with my university studies and previous experiences. And I wanted to improve my skills as a music educator. I teach music, and I I wanted to understand how the traditional musician pass on the tradition and teach to new generation how to play those folk instruments now in 2017. It was 2015, but you know, it's still the same. So I wanted to learn all these oral techniques and to understand better the music and also to teach this kind of music and any kind of music in a different way. And also to share my heritage, my music heritage here in Australia. That's what I do here as well, as a musician, as a beat maker, as an archivist and an educator. I go to schools and meet a lot of young kids and bring my old instruments and teach them how to play stuff and talk about my culture. So that's my goal. I wanted to share Italian music in Australia through performance, teaching, and documentation. That's why you say, why do you want to do that? So I think it's a very important here in Australia because Italian migration is still a very big part of our common identity, and there's not much we don't know much about it. Even in Italian community, there's not a lot of knowledge about our tradition, our music, and because for many reasons that I'm not gonna tell now, a lot of reasons. But I think there is a need to fill that lack of knowledge here, and it's kind of a mission here. But I think that is working. I hope it's not working. Yes. So I went to a big journey in southern Italy, basically. And I met with many musicians, great folk musicians from Sicily, Calabria, Campania, regional Apulia, Basilicata. And I met not only musicians, but also these music instrument makers. So I went to a very, very, the house of people, incredible tradesmen that preserved the tradition and shares with everybody and musicians and makes these instruments that are pretty rare. This is a double flute in Sicily. This is a maranzano, which is a joar. bagpipe makers, tambourine makers. So what I did is I documented those musicians and also I took lessons, as I said before, and also dancers, because dance is a big part of our culture. So back in Australia, what I want to do here, what I wanted to do here. So as I said before, I wanted to promote this culture and also preserve this culture here. And so these two elements kind of combines, because you have to make people understand what you are talking about and then actually do something. So what I did, I'm gonna produce a documentary film to promote Italian music, and also one particular aspect which is key. It's gonna be taking a little bit more than 5 minutes, I'm sorry, because so 7 minutes, okay? I thought when I first went to Italy, I thought that more, what is that in the world is most common music? Is that a question? Is I think, maybe you, not really, but it's, everybody knows what is tarantella, or have heard about this tarantella. So actually tarantella is not what we imagine, but it's a big word. It's a kind of excuse for me to show this huge word that is inside that particular word that doesn't mean anything, but means a lot of things to many people, for many people. So today I've got a launch for the first time ever. You're very lucky. the trailer of my movie that I hope to be able to finish very soon. It is called Tarantella, the Dance of the Spider. Then if you have some question about this, we can discuss it later. So this is the trailer, I hope you enjoy.
Pizzica, pizzica, il salterello e tutte le danze del nato, ok? E ce ne sono tanti, in Sicilia c'è pure la quadriglia, la contradanza, le porche addirittura se vogliamo forzare sono una specie di tarantella. Ovviamente ci sono tarantelle e tarantelle, zone e zone, quindi accenti spostati, ogni tarantella ha, come dire, i suoi accenti.
Suoniamo per far danzare, quindi spesso utilizziamo, diciamo, come la tarantella, appunto la nostra tarantella tipica, la nostra pizzica pizzica, come momento per far danzare, perché è l'unica funzione che ancora rimane tale quale. Cioè oggi come passato, alla fine la gente balla e attraverso il ballo magari può curare anche un po' se stessa.
La tarantella ti scarichi proprio, è bravo, tu sei, non pensi più a niente, diciamo.
Gira, posso sentire, gira, posso sentire, gira, posso sentire, proprio un cuore, e ci me porta l'acqua,
c'è veramente un mondo veramente complesso e immenso all'interno della tarantella.
Ancestrali che secondo me vanno diretti a quelli che sono i sentimenti, il cuore, le pulsioni primitive delle persone, quindi è universale.
First was promoting culture, Italian culture here. So the movie is one of my main objective. And the second one is maybe even bigger, is creating an archive of Italian music here in Australia. So this is very something that I would love to be involved. So what we will do, or I will do, or not myself, I need some help. Archive Epocet traditional songs, lullabies, liturgy music, folk rhymes of Italian magazines in Italia, in Australia, in audio and video format. I love video. Video archiving on traditional dances, preserve music composition, instruments and music related material pertaining to the Italian Australian community. Create a database and dedicated website, that we call. Why I want to do that? Because I want to promote a deep understanding of the Italian immaterial culture in Australia and its preservation and distribution. Avoid the loss of valuable parts of Australia's culture and history. and promote awareness of music into the Australian Italian community and the Italian Australian community in general. Thank you.